Our plan is to keep these two separated until we can determine how to mediate this without evicting them both. My name's Randy.
Yeah.
I work for your property owner. Did you go ahead and have the locks changed here?
Yes, I had the locks changed.
Okay, well, see, there's a problem with that.
Why?
Problem is, number one, your landlord does not have a copy.
And number two, I don't want my husband, soon-to-be ex-husband, to have a key.
Okay.
So that's the situation.
Well,
so thank you. I think we're done here.
We're actually not done here because I have a lease here.
Okay.
You and your husband both are on the lease. Therefore, legally, he's entitled to have a key.
No, he's not getting a copy of the key.
Hang on, Cindy. All he wants is his stuff.
Well, I can show you. I have all his stuff organized
for
him.
Okay, great.
So
show me.
I'm going to show you.
All right, you're asking me to come in.
Yes.
According to the property owner, there's been no physical violence between these two, but I'm still going to remain cautious. I'll be as empathetic as possible so we get our client's key and allow her husband to grab any belongings he might need.
Wants his stuff? Yeah, he wants his stuff. Well, he can have his half.
Oh, my God.
Next on World's Worst Tenants.
This is how you deal with things? Oh. You're seriously psychotic.
You know what it's like to have emphysema, bro?
Stay back, man, or otherwise...
Is it going to be that way?
We're in an apartment complex where a female tenant has changed the locks and illegally locked her husband and the property owner out. Now we've discovered that she's destroyed property inside in what can only have been a fit of rage.
The dining room table, which we got on our second anniversary, he can have half.
You have got to be kidding me. We've seen fighting couples cause damage to the inside of a unit, but this takes it to a whole other level.
And the TV, and they got the speakers divided up, and the couch has been halved. He can have his half.
What the hell is going on in here?
Oh my gosh, you have no idea.
Right.
This woman has taken it upon herself to go ahead and split their property.
He has half of the stuff, so now he has his half of the stuff.
Lady, I don't think that's what he meant.
If I wasn't seeing this with my own two eyes, I would have never believed it.
He always hated my cooking, so...
You cut the stove in half?
Yeah, you know, he hated my cooking.
Lady, are you off of your rocker? What this woman does with her own stuff is her business, but the stove is the owner's property, and cutting through that gas line could have blown this place sky high.
Don't even talk to her. Just calm.
I'm just gonna get my stuff.
Cool. Since this guy's on the lease, I can only hold him off for so long.
We're good? I don't know what to say. No, we're not good.
Are you kidding
me? Take a look.
She cut the bed in half? Who
chopped
the jeans in half?
She ripped the house up?
These chairs are my family.
We've had people punch holes in the walls and break glass in marital disputes before, but this is a first. This guy must have really pissed her off.
Happy second anniversary. Remember that table?
This is how you deal with things?
Oh.
You're seriously psychotic.
Oh,
these are...
I wasn't the one that put my in a 26-year-old, okay?
This is nuts.
Relax.
You cut the stove in half?
Yeah, no,
it doesn't. You
come on.
No.
Come on.
No.
Get him out of here.
No. Come on, dude.
You have no,
come on.
This is not good. Idea what is being okay.
Dude, who does that?
She does. This is a no-win situation. Right now, we need to secure the apartment and report the damage to the gas company and the property owner. But as for the husband, he's responsible for his own legal action against his wife for the personal items she destroyed.
We got everything documented, so you're good.
Okay.
You realize what you've done here could have been very dangerous for you.
Well, actually, I found a guy on the internet and he cut that part for me, and he cut the microwave too.
This doesn't even belong to you. Whoever agreed to take a torch and a power saw to this apartment is a real scumbag. It's unbelievable what people will do for cash and to other people's property.
I'm gonna give you 5 days to get a key made for your landlord and also for your husband. And I need your key right now so we can lock up, all right? The husband here did cheat on his wife with the housekeeper, so I can understand some of her anger. But she clearly crossed the line and is lucky she didn't cause an explosion. She'd be paying for a whole lot more than our client's stove.
I mean, she was clearly out of her mind.
You try something like that and see what happens to you.
Come in here.
Oh my gosh, you have no idea.
Right.
This woman has taken it upon herself to go ahead and split their property.
Half of the stuff. So now he has his half of the stuff.
Lady, I don't think that's what he meant.
If I wasn't seeing this with my own two eyes, I would have never believed it.
He always hated my cooking, so...
You cut the stove in half?
Yeah, you know, he hated my cooking.
Lady, are you off of your rocker? What this woman does with her own stuff is her business, but the stove is the owner's property, and cutting through that gas line could have blown this place sky high.
Don't even talk to her. Just calm.
I'm just going to get my stuff.
Cool. Since this guy's on the lease, I can only hold him off for so long.
We're good?
I don't know what to say. No, we're not good.
Are you
kidding me?
Take a look.
She cut the bed in half?
Who? What did she do?
Jeans in half.
She ripped the house up?
These chairs are my family.
We've had people punch holes in the walls and break glass in marital disputes before, but this is a first. This guy must have really pissed her off.
Happy second anniversary. Remember that table?
This is how you deal with things? Oh. You're seriously psychotic.
Oh, I wasn't the one that put my in a 26-year-old, okay?
This is nuts.
It goes.
You
ass.
You cut the stone in half?
Yeah, no,
you need
Come on, dude.
No, he's not getting a copy of the
key. Hang on, Cindy. All he wants is his stuff.
Well, I can show you. I have all his stuff organized
for
him.
Okay, great. So show me.
I'm going to show you.
All right, you're asking me to come in.
Yes.
According to the property owner, there's been no physical violence between these two, but I'm still going to remain cautious. I'll be as empathetic as possible so we get our client's key and allow her husband to grab any belongings he might need.
Wants his stuff? Yeah, he wants his stuff. Well, he can have his half.
Oh, my God.
Next on World's Worst Tenants.
This is how you deal with things? Oh. You're seriously psychotic.
You know what it's like to have emphysema, bro?
Yes, they're not, man. Or otherwise,
is it going to be that way?
We're at an apartment complex where a female tenant has changed the locks and illegally locked her husband and the property owner out. Now we've discovered that she's destroyed property inside in what can only have been a fit of rage.
The dining room table, which we got on our second anniversary, he can have half.
You have got to be kidding me. We've seen fighting couples cause damage to the inside of a unit, but this takes it to a whole other level.
And the TV, and we got the speakers divided up, and the couch has been halved. He can have his half.
What the hell is going on?
Now, our plan is to keep these two separated until we can determine how to mediate this without evicting them both. My name's Randy.
Yeah.
I work for your property owner. Did you go ahead and have the locks changed here?
Yes, I had the locks changed.
Okay, well, see, there's a problem with that.
Why?
Problem is, number one, your landlord does not have a copy.
And number two, I don't want my husband, soon-to-be ex-husband, to have a key.
Okay.
So that's the situation.
Well,
so thank you. I think we're done here.
We're actually not done here because I have a lease here.
Okay.
You and your husband both are on the lease. Therefore, legally, he's entitled to have a key.